Hi, and welcome to Happy Hips Yoga. All you need for this would be a mat, a nice quiet place if that's available in your home. Have a strap, maybe some blocks, and as well if you have, you know, a bolster or maybe some pillows as well. We're gonna get started by just lying down on our backs, nice and relaxed, so that those legs are open wide. You're lying down, arms are out, your shoulder blades are tucked under, your chin is to your chest slightly, lengthening the back of your neck. You don't want to put anything behind your head because we want to try and just lengthen it and then opening up those shoulders. And then just relax. Try your best to slow down your breath. So that they are just falling down to the ground. Going to begin by just bringing both of our knees up and grabbing onto them on the knees or shins and just rocking side to side. Alright, now grab onto just one and drop the other one down to the floor nice and straight. You want to bring this one that you're holding just out to the side slightly, getting closer to those ribs on the outer side of the body. And then just hold. Remembering to keep that nice, slow, and relaxed breath. With the same leg, I want you to bring that leg up, come out. You can even just grab onto the ankle if you like. What you're trying to do is bring your foot flat so it's walking on the ceiling, and that knee is on the outside of your body pulling down. If you're able, you can also grab on the outside of your foot. And if this isn't available to you, you can always grab that strap to place it around your foot to also pull it into the side. Whatever works best for you. Release that foot down to the ground. And now we're going to bring up our other leg, pulling it in nice and tight towards the outside of those ribs. Other leg is down and flat. And then just breathe. Pushing that belly into that leg. Now bring that leg up, and whichever way you chose, you're hanging on to that ankle, you're hanging on to that foot, or if you have a strap around your foot to pull it in, you go ahead and go there, remembering to bring it so that your leg is up and you're walking on that ceiling, pulling that knee down in close to those ribs. Bring both the soles of our feet to the floor, opening it up as wide as that mat, and now dropping one knee in, and then switch to the other side. So now for this next thing is we're gonna grab our strap. We're gonna place it around our foot. Bring that leg straight up into the air. And then once you find where that tension is, that feels pretty good, you're gonna wrap those hands around that strap just to hang on so that your arms aren't actually pulling. You want their arms to be relaxed and just holding that tension down. And now your other leg is gonna come down and straight. And we're just gonna hold. And remembering to use that breath to release any tension that you may feel. We're going to put the strap into one hand, or if you need both, that's okay. And we're going to open it up wide to the side, trying to keep that leg nice and straight, holding onto that strap, but then making sure that your other shoulder is relaxed down onto that floor. To your toe and hold on to it a little bit snugger, you're welcome to do that, and then you don't have to use the strap. Let's bring it all the way back up. Still nice and straight. And now we're going to bring it just a few inches across our body. Just a little bit. Let's continue it across our body, trying to still keep it straight. You should be feeling this nice stretch all the way through. And then again, making sure that opposite shoulder is still flat on the floor. continuing to pull it in just a little further. Strap in your hands and bring it out wide. Making sure it's nice and straight. And if you can grab onto that toe, feel free. Let's bring it all the way back up. We're going to cross it over our body just slightly, trying to still keep that leg nice and straight. Thank you. let's cross it further, keeping that leg straight, and then that shoulder still out to the side. Exhales to just release all of that pain and discomfort. All the way back up again, and then let's see if we can bring it in just a little bit more or straighten that leg just a little bit higher. Strap just to the side. Again, with your feet flat on the floor, I just want you to dip inside to side. All right, so now the next thing we're going to do is cross that leg over, and then let's push your knee out. If this is enough and this feels like a great stretch, just stay right there. If you want this to be slightly more intensified, bring it up and place your hands around that thigh, but make sure that your head and your neck are down on that floor. If you need something between the two of those, you are welcome to bring a strap in and around that thigh. If you need to, bring it off the floor slightly, but not quite in enough to grab on. If this stretch isn't enough, you can also grab onto the outside of that shin to pull it in even further. But make sure that that knee is open, wide, and out to the side, regardless of which version you choose. Release that foot down, but keep your leg crossed. I want you to reach out and grab onto that ankle And then we're gonna drop your foot down to the side, twisting your body and keeping that foot up nice and close. That's why we're grabbing onto it with our ankle. And now bring your other arm out to the side and then look over that arm. You should be feeling it, a bit of a stretch in your sides, perhaps in your hips, along your IT band. Lots of different places. Bring it all the way back up, and we're going to switch feet. Crossing over the other side, again, staying here, pushing that leg out, or bringing it in, grabbing onto that thigh, bringing a strap around and holding onto that thigh, or grabbing onto that shin. You choose whichever version you feel like doing on this leg. It is possible that this leg will need something different than the other leg, depending on how tight it may be. Maybe take a note of the fact that maybe one side is tighter than the other, and then maybe incorporate the stretch, especially on that really tight side, in every single day. Put that foot down, reach out and grab your ankle, and twist until your hip touches the ground. All right, let's bring it back up. Bring those knees back into that chest and just give it a rock side to side. Maybe do a few circles, bring it around in one direction and then around in the other direction. Good. We're gonna go over to one side, just have just a little break. And then if you feel all right to sit up, please feel free to come on up to seated. And then you're gonna wanna have your blocks and your straps nice and close by. You're welcome to grab a drink of water this time as well. All right, so our first exercise that we're going to do while we're sitting is one leg is in, and one leg is out. We're gonna twist towards that leg that's out, so our body is facing it. And then we're gonna come down. If coming down to reach that leg is not really easy, please feel free to put a strap around that foot to pull and to bring yourself forward. You could just lay on that leg or grab onto your foot as well. You choose what's right for you. Switch. One leg is out, one leg is bent in. We're going to twist towards that leg that's out and then come on down. This next really fun one is going to be fire log. So there are different options if you are not a fan of this. I'm just going to turn sideways so you can see a little better. So what you're going to do is, if this is enough for you, stay here. This is fine. If being like this is painful, having your knees open, you're always welcome to bring your blocks in to just give it that support if that's something that you need. That's what those blocks are for. If you want to try the full fire lock, what you're going to do is, you see when my legs are crossed, I have it pulled in. You want to bring it out so that it is straight and in front of us. You also want to engage your shin, so bringing that foot up a bit, that will protect your knee. Your other leg is going to come in, but it's going on top of that knee. So not in here, up here. And then now this knee is going to come down, trying to make it to here, also engaging that foot. And then if you're not able to get it down there to relax it, you are welcome to bring that block to put it here. And if this is what feels painfully nice, feel free to be there. If you want to challenge yourself further, you can take that block out, and then either way, block in or out, you're welcome to lean forward and then lay over on top of those legs. side to side. So allow your hips to just relax a little from that. But we are going to do the other side. So once you feel ready, we're going to bring that leg across for that bottom leg. And now we're bringing the other leg on top and then seeing if we can get it to drop down. You may find that one hip may be tighter than the other, and so you're always welcome to put that block there if you're finding you need it. And then once you feel ready, you're welcome to come forward to relax it down. Now let's put our feet out in front. You're welcome to have a strap if you like. And we're going to be pulling forward and keeping those toes up and straight. We don't want them to flail out. We don't want them to come in. We want them nice and straight and up while you lean forward. If you have that control with your feet without having to use your strap, feel free to come down and just grab those ankles. And then bring your legs together with the help of your hands. When you go to stretch something, you don't want to engage those muscles to bring them back fast. You want to just bring them back nice and slow and assist them. And since our arms weren't being stretched, they won't be able to do that. So our next thing we're going to do is we're going to flip over onto our hands and knees. Again, at this time, if you need a glass of water, please feel free. So we will be on our hands and knees. I want your knees to be open wide and your feet together. Just sit back and then bring your hands as forward as you're able. And then once you've reached as far as you can, I want you to drop your chest to the floor and then lower that head. I want you to come up just slightly, bring yourself over to one side, again reaching those hands out and then dropping down. Let's come up and we're going to go over to the other side, reaching those hands out. Thank you. And then come down at center again. Back up to all fours. You may want to have your blocks on either side, nice and close, if you decide to use them. What we're going to do is we're going to bring one leg forward, sneaking our toes as forward as we can, because when we go to push our hips forward, our knee is not going to go past those toes. You want your chest up onto that knee. You can hold there, or you can have your blocks on either side, whatever works for you. You're focusing at getting those hips forward, but then that chest has to be up. We are trying to get into our hip flexor, and that crosses our hip. So bent forward, we're getting into it slightly, but to really get into it fully, we have to be up high with those hips forward. Again, you can have those blocks available. Straighten that leg in front, and then I want you to lean forward. Once you find that nice stretch, also tuck that chin to your chest. Let's lean all the way back, straightening that front leg, and then coming down in front, and then tucking that chin to that chest. Spot. I'm going to use that first. And so lie down nice and flat. We're going to bring those feet in, knees bent. Bring this block underneath and placing it where that flat bone in your low back is. But then I want to make sure that that block is just below those dimples that are in your back, right below to your SI joints. And then relax it there. Make sure those shoulder blades are tucked under, arms are wide, chin to chest. And then if you want, you are welcome to bring those legs down and open if that feels right for you. If it doesn't, bring those knees back up, open your feet nice and wide, and then drop your knees in together. If you have your legs down, bring them up, bring your feet in nice and close. I want you to lift up just to remove that block, but now dropping from vertebrae to vertebrae all the way down your back until your back is nice and flat on that floor. You can open up those legs, and this is where that bolster is going to come in, as you can place it under those knees. Down, shoulder blades flat, neck tucked, neck long. Open those hands and then relax. Release your oxygen with some sighs, maybe. Take a big yawn and just let it all go. I want to thank you for taking my Happy Hips yoga class. My name is Laura, and I hope to see you next time, either in class or on another recorded video. Please take your time in getting up. You're welcome to just lie here for just a little extra. I will continue the music ongoing. Try and give yourself at least 5 to maybe 10 minutes worth of time of just breathing and relaxing and accepting all the great stretches that you just gave your body. Thanks again for joining. Namaste.
Thank you.